So the way I look at the possibilities, and there may be more, this is just my opinion, but you get the diagnosis, and either the patients opt out of any treatments, which they had recommended for me at the beginning. You have a conventional approach where you go from one doctor's office to another doctor's office, and 3 weeks later you go to another doctor's office, and then the patient's left trying to figure out all this information that may not even be the same type of recommendations. The medical guy saying take chemotherapy, a surgeon saying, yeah, let's try surgery, and the radiation guy saying, oh, let me do some radiation on it first. Or you can have the conference approach, like at Vanderbilt, where they have a tumor board that meets, and hopefully they come back with the idea that they're going to give you the right information. But in my case, I happened to find out that the medical oncologist was so against me having surgery, he told me the surgeon refused when he, in fact, agreed to do my surgery. And then there's the true multi-D approach, where you get all these doctors in the same room and the patient's able to listen to the discussions and can understand exactly why you want to do chemotherapy first and then maybe surgery, or why you would do surgery first and then chemotherapy. Well, just since my diagnosis 8 years ago, I think this is astounding. There's 1.5 million people that have been diagnosed with lung cancer. But what's crazy is 1,322,000 of them have already died. And that is just unacceptable. Oh gosh. So anyway, I'm an advocate. I didn't know it was going to do this. I'm sorry. I'm just going to go ahead and click on these. I do quite a bit with advocacy. I work with ECOG, 10 national meetings. I'm an advocate with the Vanderbilt Lung Spore, numerous newspaper articles and Wall Street Journals. I've been in magazine articles talking about lung cancer. I've worked with Lance Armstrong, and I'm also in the book, The Lung Cancer Advocate. But the proudest thing I think that we've been able to do is I'm a co-founder of the Lung Cancer Foundation of America, and our sole purpose is to raise money for lung cancer research. Challenges for lung cancer patients. I think lung cancer patients get a double whammy. It's hard enough to have cancer, but for lung cancer patients, the statistics scare you off before you ever start. We have all the well-known problems that exist for all lung cancer patients: the lack of awareness, lack of support. There's hardly any lung cancer support groups. I tried to do a lung cancer support group, and actually the patients got kind of intimidated, because as they came and they saw patients die, they felt it was rather depressing. I think there's a lack of sympathy and understanding. I have yet to tell anybody I have lung cancer in which the statement doesn't come up at some point, usually the first question, if not the first, second, and sometimes a little further in the conversation. But people want to know, well, did you smoke? Did you do this to yourself? And I used to be kind of rude about it and say, are you suggesting that I created my own illness? But then I realized they really are not meaning to be rude. They're not intending any wrong in it. It's just society. We've just assigned that to lung cancer patients. And by the way, just so y'all know, I did smoke when I was in college, okay? My oldest daughter's 21. I had quit before she was born, but I smoked some in college. There's a lack of funding, a huge lack of funding, which leads to the lack of progress. And a lack of clinical trials. There's a lack of clinical trials for lung cancer patients, and there's a lack of accrual to clinical trials. Overall, clinical trials will only accrue, like 3 to 4% of adult population will go on a clinical trial. For lung cancer, it's only half of that. So our progress is very slow, even if we have any progress. Within the medical community, now this isn't so much at cancer centers and to you all, but within the medical community, the community doctors, they don't have knowledge about the newest treatments. they don't have any hope for lung cancer patients. My first oncologist, she never spoke a word to me, but what she wasn't shaking her head. And I was asking her, what about clinical trials? You know, are you telling me you don't have any survivors of this? And everything she said to me was in it was shaking her head no. You know, not in this case, she would say. No. You know, this is too bad. I think there's a lack of appropriate staging in the community, and there's a lack of appropriate management of patients, because the cardiothoracic surgeons don't always do lymph node resection. And I think it's critical for lung cancer patients. Fighting the disease is hard enough. We shouldn't have to fight for proper care as well. So how can we do better? As doctors, I would ask you not to focus on the statistics. It's great for you guys to figure out if what you're doing is on the mark. But for a patient, I don't want to know what the statistics are. Matter of fact, they're old news to me. Statistics are based on what's happened in the history. It doesn't tell me what's going to happen to me. Refer your patients to proper specialists. Of course, you guys are the proper specialists. Encourage clinical trial participation. Offer lung cancer support groups in your community. Communicate with each other and the patient. And let your patients tell you when they're ready to give up. In my case, I was so healthy. And I remember thinking in front of the doctor, there was one that was really kind of fat. And he's telling me I'm going to die. And I'm thinking, I'm healthier than you are. And the end thing is never still anyone's hope. You know, I don't care how many initials you have behind your name. Nobody has the right to take away someone's hope. It's not false hope. It's just hope of another day. And it's essential to life. Together, I think we can make a difference for lung cancer. We can change the course of this disease, but it's going to take the patients becoming survivors who can become advocates and the medical community. Thank you.